Welcome to the BGFG stick style unboxing of the PDP Victrix Pro BGFG controller. This comes for both PlayStation and Xbox. The Xbox version comes in white and black with purple highlights, and the PlayStation one comes with black and purple highlights, as well as a blue camouflage, digital camouflage, and a white one for your PlayStation fans. This MSRP is at $180, and let's take a look at what's in the box. All right, like we talked about before, here's the Victrix Pro BFG for the PlayStation. I'm really hoping this is going to be everything I think it's going to be. One would hope. Let's see if I can even get it open. Of course not. Yeah, because I forgot one. Let's take care of that real quick. I don't know why I only thought there would be one, not more than one, but now that's open. So let's see what we have. Open it up here. Ooh, wait. Come on, open it up. Oh, it's a tight fit. Oh, that's a tight fit. All right. Come on, a little bit more. A little bit more. Here we go. All right, so already we start off with a really nice case. It is nice. And we have our starter. Access the quick start guide. And that's all, really. There's nothing else in here. Some just quick pieces of information. Put that over. Bring this back up, and it's not too bad. So let's open it up, see what we have. I like these cases. I like how they're doing this with a lot of the controllers now. Zipper's a lot easier to open than most of the other stuff. Looking at you, Sony. Oh, and as I open it, so on the top we have kind of your basics. It's wrapped right in there. Purple, looks like a USB, and then here's the controller itself. So we have our controller. We have what looks like spare keys. Wow. Holy crap. There's a lot of stuff in here. So we have our two different sized thumbsticks. We have our cute little Victrix screwdriver. Two keypads. What are these? No, these are just holders. No reason for those. We have our button layout. So there you have the ring. Or basically the thumbsticks, instead of having a round one, you can have the octagon. Of course, the USB to connect everything. So I got to find room for that someplace. And then finally, the button set. So it looks like it's a pretty easy. Oh, see, they're going to be locked. So what we were talking about on the show is probably not going to happen, because you see two channels here and a single one here. These little notches are going to block what I kind of want to do, I'm pretty sure. So let's close all this up and let's get into the controller itself, which is relatively nice. Feels good, not super heavy. I'm going to have to charge it first, of course. And it's a USB-C charger right there. And you're going to have your different triggers feel good. Bumpers feel good. The controller feels good. D-pad is really nice. But then the question I have is, how do I get into this? And that's what these little screws most likely are for. So you have your earpiece. You have Wi-Fi or connected or battery. PlayStation button. Not even sure what all these buttons do, but I do like the way the flappy paddles are in the back. That's pretty cool. So let's break out the... Yeah, let's just break out the screwdriver. Let's see if we can't get into some trouble. There we go. All right. Let's break this out and we'll see. I unscrew this here. Watch me lose the screws. That would suck. I don't think they're kept in here, but we'll find out shortly. So the whole idea of this, nice, comes out nice and smooth. Let's see if the screws drop out. They do not. But when you do disconnect it, the top piece comes off. That's kind of cool. So I can put in the different channel pieces. Yeah, see, they pop right out and pop right in. I'm not going to mess with that quite yet. I'm pretty confident I'm not going to keep this. The way it's looking right now, I'm not. So this guide right here is what's going to stay with it all the time. And my goal is to get, see, it's got, I don't know if this is going to work. So these don't have the lock-in. So theoretically, I can spin it so it's this way. You can have them two at the same time, which is very PlayStation. Or I can flip it this way and have it Xbox style. Now, my goal originally was to see if we can get this to go up here. And if we can, that's a bonus. But I'm betting it's not going to. I'm betting that these pieces right here and right here are going to dictate how it sits on this side, which is not going to be really good. I'm already debating whether I'm even going to use it to play. Because I just, the whole goal of this was to get thumbsticks at a higher point for people with big old mitts like mine. And as it comes out, as you can see, one and two. So now the question is, of course, this will naturally drop in there. And it won't drop in that way. I have to drop it in this way. But let's see if the other side will drop in. Nope. And nope, you cannot put that on this side. So to me, not going to be worth it. I like the idea that I can flip this and I can have it very much like a PlayStation controller with the two down here. I do like that. I'm not going to lie, but I wanted them both up here. I wanted both of the thumbsticks up top. And I think that's just I think that's a fail. I do. I think the controller is pretty awesome. I'll even give it a whirl. And see if I can get it to play and connect. But to me, that's a bummer right there. I'm going to keep it configured like this for now. And what we'll do is we'll utilize it on a game and see if we can get it set up to the PlayStation. But even then, I'm not even sure if I want to do that because it's really going to be a situation where I'm probably not going to like the way this. It's not going to feel any different than anything else. The flappy paddles are nice. Some of the design is really nice, but I don't feel that I'm going to have any use outside of the regular PlayStation controls. Not to mention the PlayStation Pro is, I feel, a better controller. I still feel, you've heard me say it on the show numerous times, that I feel that that is the best controller on the market right now, bar none. Now, there's an argument to be made for all of that. I don't disagree. There's people that are going to sit there and tell me that I'm an idiot and I've never played with Scuf, and I've never played with, you know, whatever they feel like saying. But I still feel that right now, this controller right here is the best controller on the market. I don't even have the nubs in. But I just feel it. It feels good. It looks good. It plays well. I just feel this is the best one. This is significantly lighter, but it doesn't feel any different. I don't think there's going to be a huge change. So as you can see, relatively good controller. Really no complaints as a controller, but the whole thing that we were trying to do on BGFG that we were talking about and on Stick Style, if you're gaming with us, is that we were hoping that we could flip that left side to make it a controller that for bigger people's hands, like mitts like mine, that you would have two thumbsticks on the top sides. That's just not going to happen. Because the left side, or I should say the right side, is only good if you're a fighter gamer where you can have those six buttons. Or you can flip the left side so that you have a more PlayStation controller, PlayStation joysticks on an Xbox controller. That's basically all it is. You can have the size of an Xbox with a PlayStation configuration thumbsticks, or you can play on the PlayStation with an Xbox size controller with the PlayStation thumbsticks where they usually are. Again, at $180, I didn't see the point in trying this out and testing it and showing a video for that because it's just not something I'm interested in. The whole point that we were talking about on the show was to have the thumbsticks on the top. And you can't do that. I have plenty of other controllers that I've reviewed in the past that are probably better than this. The weight's good. The flappy paddles on the back are cool. But unless you're a fighting gamer like you play fighter games, I think this is a pass. So unfortunately, it's not something we're going to keep around the studio. Thanks for watching.